So in the last class, we have seen about the composition of local anesthesia, the classification, the details of how each component in the local anesthesia works, all those things. So from this class onwards, we will see the techniques of maxillary and mandibular local anesthesia, for achieving the anesthesia in the maxillary and mandibular arches. So before going to the techniques, what we need to know is about the nerves which supply the teeth, or the nerves which supply the buccal mucosa and the palatal mucosa in the maxillary, and the buccal mucosa and the lingual mucosa of the mandibular arch. Coming to the maxillary arch, we mainly have three nerves. One is the anterior superior, middle superior and posterior superior supplying the buccal aspect, and the nasopalatine and greater palatine supplying the palatal aspect. Talking about the anterior superior is the one which supplies the buccal aspect, or the front portion, buccal aspect, buccal mucosa, buccal bone of the anterior teeth from the central incisor, lateral incisor to the carina. Middle superior supplying the premolars and the mesopalatal root of the first molar, and posterior superior supplying from there onwards backward. And up to the palatal side, we have two main, the nasopalatine supplying till the premolars from the anteriors, and the greater palatine supplying in the posterior region. So when we need to extract a particular tooth, we need to think of the nerve supply and anesthetize the nerve, whichever respective test one is supplying the particular tooth. Turning on to the anterior branches, anterior superior, middle superior. Anterior superior and middle superior are marked two different nerves. It is, they are the two branches of the infravital nerve. The infravital nerve, once it comes out of the infravital foramen, it branches into two, as the anterior and the middle superior are here. So we will go into each block in detail. See, talking about the posterior superior anterior nerve block. It is one of the frequently used nerve blocks in dentistry. The anesthetic solution is deposited behind the tuberosity, near to the posterior superior anterior nerve, before it enters the maxillary sinus. We need to take a look at the photo. See, in this, the maxillary, the posterior maxillary is applied at the posterior superior anterior nerve, where the posterior superior anterior nerve comes out at a position above the mucobuccal fold of the second molar. So that is the place where we are catching the posterior superior anterior nerve. Anesthetizing the posterior superior will get an anesthesia from the first molar to the third molar, except the mesopalatal root of the first molar. That is always a difference. You should always remember, before for extracting a first molar, you can always go for infiltration just because it's a maxilla. Otherwise, you have to anesthetize two different nerves. One is the middle superior and posterior superior for getting a buccal anesthesia. See, the needle should be angled at 30 to 45 degrees towards the mucobuccal fold above the second molar, so that it reaches the nerve before it enters the maxillary sinus. So when we angle the needle like this, we should also be very much aware of the venous plexus, which lies in the cerebrovalentine area. If we advance the needle very much forward and reach the venous plexus area, it will start bleeding, and it leads to the most common complication, which is accounted for the posterior superior nerve block, which is the hematoma, posterior superior hematoma, and that accounts for the most common complication. As we advance the needle much forward, where we are not getting enough bone head, we advance and it goes and punctures the venous plexus. So always when we advance the needle to the posterior superior nerve block, we should be very careful that we don't go inside more than 2 to 3 millimeters. So the complications, as we have already said, is hematoma, the most commonly produced by inserting the little too far posteriorly in the tenderized venous plexus. In addition, maxillary artery perforated and use of short needle devices